amazing father. I never thought this day would come. To me, as many of you, my father was a real Superman. Since the day he was viciously shot, my father faced an endless amount of hardship that most of us here will never be able to imagine. However, my father got up every day, kept the faith in Jesus Christ, and conquered his life, despite being in a wheelchair dependent on a ventilator. There are many ups and downs, lots of tears shed, but more hope shared. He was the greatest man that I could ask to be my father. From always being on the sideline, rooting for me during my Shamnot sports days, making a weekly visit to Boston College, just to have lunch at Applebee's, and calling me every day at 5 a.m., every day, to say good morning while I was patrolling the streets of this great city. My father was always committed to me. He did more than most able-bodied fathers could ever do with their sons. I most cherish times when we used to watch our beloved New York Rangers in the Zamboni area and Madison Square Garden. Such magnificent times. My dad loved life. He lived to the fullest with the amazing care of his nurses, doctors, physical therapists, and the police officers who drove him every day. My dad wanted to make sure his time on earth was not wasted. That is why he was so passionate in spreading God's message of love, compassion, and forgiveness. When many of us have let anger destroy our hearts, my father forgave a young man who shot him every single day. He made it his mission to have all us realize that love must win. My father was so proud to be a veteran of the Navy, where he was a corpsman to the Marines. Even more, his dream came true when he joined the greatest job in the greatest city in July of 1984. My dad loved the NYPD until the end. He loved the shield, he loved the uniform, he loved his bosses, he loved the men and women who wake up every day to protect this city. It was an honor and privilege for him. When God made my dad as a cop, he broke the mold. He's a legend who will never have a comparison. Ultimately, my dad talked about his beautiful and most loyal bride, my mother, Patty Ann.
Where there's sadness, joy.
Prime Minister, great that I'm an episode to seek to be consoled as to be sold, to be understood as to understand, and to be loved as to love. For it is a given that we receive, it is imparted that we are born, pardoned, and it is dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. God bless America, our city, New York,